Have you ever had to join a new team and jump into coding quickly, but found that setting up all the tools and external libraries is taking forever? I know the last thing I need when approaching a deadline is to spend time trying to make my project build. That's why Android Studio includes a simple-to-use and powerful build system based on Gradle that makes you more productive from the get-go. It favors convention over configuration, giving you same defaults to get you started, while still allowing for more advanced features like better library management, built-in multi-APK support, and more. Let me show you a few examples. Your build configuration and all your project's dependencies are kept in Gradle build files using an intuitive declarative syntax. These files are the single source of truth about your project. What this means is essentially that any changes you make here will be automatically reflected in the IDE. So features like code completion, for example, are always up to date with your project's configuration. Even better, the same build files can also be used by Gradle on the command line and in your continuous integration server, ensuring consistent and reproducible builds in any environment. When you've spent years with Ant or Eclipse, it is a big task to learn a new build system. That's why, when importing a project from Eclipse, Android Studio automatically creates Gradle files for you and even identifies commonly used libraries and brings them in as dependencies. The basic configuration for your app, like the application ID, minimum and target SDK, and versioning information, are now declared in the default config section of the build file. You can also see any local and remote libraries that your project depends on in the dependencies section. In the case when Android Studio fails to recognize your dependency when importing a project, or if you're just looking to add a new library, you can easily find out the right package name and version to put here by using the Maven search dialog. If you're still confused and just want to get started quickly, you can get some examples of useful libraries like the AppCompat and others on the Gradle Please website. Another challenge when creating or using third-party libraries was that there used to be no efficient way to distribute additional Android-specific resources along with code. You either had to move directories around or be limited to a jar file, which can only contain Java classes. With Gradle, we've introduced support for the Android Archive Format, AAR for short, which lets you publish or attach to your project a self-contained library with all its resources, assets, and even manifest entries. But there is so much more in Android Studio than just better library management. Have you ever had to build multiple versions of your app and deal with code duplication or other workarounds? With the flexibility of Gradle, you can now create different variants of the same application from a single project. You get the debug and release build types by default, and together with product flavors that you set up, they create what we call build variants. Build types and product flavors are a very powerful and customizable concept. For example, you can define separate signing configurations for each build type. Or, if you want to upload a free and paid version of your app to the Play Store, you can override the application ID, previously known as package name, for both flavors. Easy! Moreover, each type, flavor, and variant can contain its own bits of code and resources, which will be merged with the main code base. It's even possible to specify additional permissions and components, or override manifest settings that you only want to have in certain flavors, but not in others. You can use this mechanism together with multi-APK support in the Play Store to create and publish device-specific APKs for different screen densities, CPU types, or API levels. The important wins here are a better developer experience for you and smaller download sizes for your users. When working with variants, Android Studio will only show files relevant to the currently selected version in the project overview. To change which version of your app you want to work on, use the Build Variants pane. You can also check out all the automatically generated build tasks for each of your variants in the Gradle sidebar. Just use the Assemble task if you want to build all possible configurations of your app. As you can see, with Android Studio, we finally have a modern, powerful build system that takes the pain out of managing your projects. We've just scratched the surface of what's possible with Gradle in this video. So if you have any other questions, join our community on Google+. See you in the next Android Studio videos very soon.